सरस्वती रक्षमा।
जय गुरु शिव गुरु हरि गुरु राम जगत गुरु परम गुरु सद्गुरु श्याम।
जय गुरु शिव गुरु हरि गुरु राम जगत गुरु परम गुरु सद्गुरु श्याम।
आदि गुरु अद्वैत गुरु आनंद गुरु
Rama, 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 Rama.
bicycle to get a human birth. Therefore, try your best to realize in this birth.
It is difficult.
Can you expect real shambi if you waste your time in cotton cinema?
Can you expect real shambi if you waste your time in cotton cinema?
In cotton gambling,
in cotton gambling,
in scandal backbiting. Gossiping,
gossiping.
When your throat is choked at the time of death, who will help you for your salvation?
When your throat is choked at the time of death, who will help you for your salvation?
The time sweeps away, kings and barons. Where is Napoleon? Where is Nero? Time slips away, presidents, prime ministers. Where is Kennedy? Where is Indira? Up and doing in yogic sadhan, you will attain immortality.
Up and doing yogic sadhan, you will attain immortality.
Be up and doing in japa meditation, you will attain supreme peace. Up and doing in asana pranayam, you will attain supreme health.
Up and doing asana pranayam, you will attain supreme health.
Eat a little, drink juice a little, talk a little, sleep a little. Asana a little, pranayam little, do japa a little, meditate a
little.
Mix a little, move a little, walk a little, talk a little.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय
ओम नमः शिवाय Yeah.
वंदे जगद्गुरुम् कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं श्रीकृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं
कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं
कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं श्रीकृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं
कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं
आनन्दं ब्रह्मानन्दम्
आनन्दो आनन्दो आनन्दं ब्रह्मानन्दम्
आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दं ब्रह्मानन्दम्
आनन्दो absolute bliss I am.
I am bliss, I am bliss, bliss, absolute bliss I am.
Anandoham, anandoham, anandam brahmanandam. परिपूर्ण शिवोऽहं नित्यानन्द स्वरूप शिवोऽहं
आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्द ब्रह्मानन्दम्
साक्षि चेतन कूटस्थोऽहं नित्यानित्य स्वरूप शिवोऽहम्
आनन्दोऽहम्
ब्रह्मानन्दम्
आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दोऽहम्
आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दं ब्रह्मानन्दम्
आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दं ब्रह्मानन्दम्
आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दोऽहम् आनन्दम् बारी रंजन राम राम पाप विमोचन राम राम
पशुपति रंजन राम राम पाप विमोचन राम राम
मणिमय भूषण राम राम मंजुल भाषण राम राम भूषण राम राम मणिमय भूषण राम राम मंजुल भाषण राम राम भूषण राम राम
मुरारी
यमुना तीर विहारी वृंदावन संजारी
यमुना तीर विहारी वृंदावन संजारी
गोवर्धन गिरिधारी गोपाल कृष्ण मुरारी रवियारे वृंदावन संजारे गोवर्धन गिरिधारी गोपाल कृष्ण मुरारी गुरुदेव जय जय गुरुदेव
वंदे गुरुदेव जय जय गुरुदेव
जय जय गुरुदेव
वंदे गुरुदेव जय जय गुरुदेव
जय श्री गुरुदेव जय जय गुरुदेव शिवानंद गुरुदेव
वंदे गुरुदेव शिवानंद गुरुदेव
ॐ ॐ शं नो मित्र शं वरुणः शम न इंद्रो बृहस्पति शम नो विष्णुरुक्रम नमो ब्रह्मणे
नमस्ते वायो
त्वमेव देव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वामेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्म वदिष्यामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवदु तद्वक्तारमवदु अवतु माम् अवदु वक्तारम् शांति शांति शांतिः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्युषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐमाप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक्प्राणचक्षुश्रोत्रम् अधो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदम् माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यात् मम ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्तु अनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्माः ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ भद्रं कर्णेभि शृणुयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्ये माक्षभिरजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैर्ष्टु वागुंस तनोभिः विषेम देवहितम् यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति न पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्ताक्ष्यो अरिष्ठनेमिः स्वस्तिनो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ब्रह्मानन्दं परमसुखदम् केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिम् द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशम् तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यम् विमलमचलम् सर्वती साक्षिभूतम् भावातीदं त्रिगुणरहितम् सद्गुरुं तं नमामि चैतन्यं शाश्वतं शान्तम् निराकारं निरञ्जनं नादबिन्दुकलातीदम् तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः गुरुब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरा गुरुसाक्षात्परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाघया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः ध्यानमूलं गुरोर्मूर्तिं पूजामूलं गुरोर्पदम् मन्त्रमूलं गुरोर्वाक्यम् मोक्षमूलं गुरोर्कृपा ॐ नमः शिवाय गुरवे सच्चिदानन्दमूर्ते निष्पभञ्जाय शान्ताय शिवानन्दाय ते नमः ॐ प्रदस्मरामि सदन्दुकरज्ज्वलाभं सन्दन्दवन्मकरकुण्डलहारभूषम् दिव्यायुतोर्जितनीलसहस्रहस्तां रक्तोद्भुलाविजरणं भवदीं परेशां प्रथममेषात्रचन्द्रमुण्डशिम्बासुरपुरन्दविनाशदक्षां ब्रह्मेन्द्ररुद्रमुनिमोहनशीललीलां चण्डीं समस्तसुरमूर्तिमनेकरूपां प्राद्भिजविराटधात्रीं धात्रीं समस्यं दुरिदावहन्त्रीं संसारबन्धनविमोचनहेतुभूतां मायां परां समधिगम्यपर स विष्णोः ॐ शिववाजादेविक्तम्बक्सुलभे सर्वकारविधाने कलोहे कालसिद्धतुं वामरत्न देवी विवाज चिन्दे पर्वक्षामि कलो सर्वेषु साधनमयाद्वष्णपम्बासि प्रकाशदे ॐ अस्य श्रीदुर्गा सप्तशतमन्तस्य नारायणचन्दहासि महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वत्यो देवताः ॐ श्रीदुर्गा प्रीर्थतम् सप्तलोकपाठे विनियोगः ॐ जं चदांसि देवी भवतिसा पदादायुष्यमहाय महामाया प्रस्यते दुर्गे स्मृता हरसि भीतिमशेषचन्दो स्वस्ते स्मृता मतिमतिव शुभां ददासि दारिद्र्यदुःखभयहारिणिकादधन्या सर्ववन सदा दजितां सर्वमङ्गलमाङ्गल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थसाधिके शरण्ये त्र्यम्बके गौरी नारायणी नमोऽस्तुते शरणागत दीनार्थ परित्राणपरायणे सर्वस्यातिहरे देवी नारायणी नमोऽस्तुते सर्वस्वरूपे सर्वेशे सर्वशक्तिसमन्विते भयेभ्यस्त्राहिनो देवी दुर्गे देवी नमोऽस्तुते रोगान् शेषान् पुंसदुष्टारुष्टादु कामन् सलान् भीष्टान् त्वामाशिदान् विपन्नराणं त्वामाशिदा ह्याशेदां प्रयान्ति सर्वाबाधा प्रशुम्तलकस्याखिले श्रीं दया कर्मस्मद्वैर्विनाशनं ॐ सप्तश्लोकदुर्गासं दुर्गाष्टोत्तर शतनामस्तुतम् ईशुरुवाजां शतनाम प्रवक्ष्यामि शनिशकमलाने यस्य प्रसादमात्रेण दुर्गा प्रीदा भवेच्छनं सरी साधि प्रीदा भवानी भयमोचिनी आर्या दुर्गा जद्यादिनेत्रा शूलधारिणी पिनाधारिणि चित्रा जनकण्डा महादभाः मनुभ्रङ्गारा चित्रुवाचिराजिदे सर्वमन्त्रमे सत्ता सत्यानन्दस्वरूपिनन्दा भाविनी भाव्या भव्या भव्या सदागते शाम्भवी देवमाता जाचिन्दारत्नप्रियादा सर्विद्या दक्षण्या दक्षविनाशनपर्णा नेकवर्णा जा पाटला पाटलावती पटाम्बरपरिधाना कलमञ्जिरञ्जनविक्रमा क्रूरा सुन्दरी सुसुन्दरं दुर्गाजमानङ्गी मदङ्गमनुभुजदा ब्राह्मी माहेश्वरीचन्द्री कौमारी वैष्णवी तथा चामुण्डा चौवाराकी लक्ष्मी च भुषादमुत्कृष्टज्ञानक्रिया नित्याजबुद्धा बोला बहुलप्रेमा सर्ववाहन वाहना निशुम्भशुम्भनिमश्रासनमद्दिनी मधुकैटभन्द्री जय चन्द्रमुण्ड विनाशिनी सर्वासु विनाशा जय सर्वदानविघातिनी सर्वशास्त्रमे सत्या सर्वासुद्धारिणीतधा अनेक शतहस्ताजने एकाथसुधारिणी कुमारी जगिन्या जा कौशोरी उदय प्रौढा च प्रौढा जा विद्धमादाबलपदाम्बोदं केशी गौररूपा महाबला अग्निज्वाला रौद्रं गे कालरात्रिनारायणी भद्रकाली विष्णुमाया जलोदरी शिवदूती कराल जनन्दा परमेश्वरी कात्यान सावती भद्रक्षा प्रमोहादिनीं एदम प्रभृ नित्यम दुर्गा राम सदा अष्टकम नासादम दे देवी इति श्लोकेषु पार्वती धनम धनम सदम जायाम हम हस्तम चतुर्वर्गम तदा चंदे लभेन मुक्तिम च शाश्वतीम कुमारीम पूजित्वा दुधात्वा देवीम सुरेश्वरीम पूजयत प्रवक्ता भरन नाम सदा अष्टकम सस्वृद्धि भवे देवी सर्वे सर्वरे रवि राजन दौतम्यादि राजस्मी अपनिया देव गौरजना रत कुंगुमेन सिंदूर कर्पूर मृत्युलिखारे देवरारी भमावासम निशाग्रे चंद्रे चलभिषांग देवलिख प्रवरे स्तोत्रदम ओं दुर्गाष्टोत्र चतुर्नाम संपूर्ण ओं गड्गम चबरीगाशुरशी शरशंगं सर्वांगभूषावधाम नीलांशिवासी देवे महाकालिकां यम सखरो मदुंगडभम ओम विद्युता प्रभा मगलस्कंदा भीषण कनखस्तापिरासेम जामंगलम दज्जनी बिभ्राणाम अनिलात्मिका शशिधरां दुर्गां दिनेत्रां भजे दुर्गां दिनेत्रां भजे दुर्गां दिनेत्रां भजे ओम श्री दुर्गा 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 नम ओम श्री दुर्गा नम ओम श्री दुर्गा नम ओम श्री दुर्गाय नमः 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 ओम श्री दुर्गार्पणमस्तु ओम श्री दुर्गार्पणमस्तु ओम श्री दुर्गार्पणमस्तु ओम नमो नारायणाय दासगंधर्व केशव 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 ओं नमो नारायणाय दासगंधर्वकेशवा ओं नमो नारायणाय दासगंधर्वकेशवा ओं नमो नारायणाय दासगंधर्वकेशवा ओम शांति 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 ओम नारायणार्पणमस्तु ओम शांति 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 ओम नारायणार्पणमस्तु ओम शांति 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 ओम नमो नारायणाय ॐ 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 शान्ति
शान्ति शान्ति
ओम नमः शिवाय। हवारी बाबू चमन लाल जी महाराज हवारी खेम छे सारू छे ठीक छे मजा में छे वेल फास्ट हियर।
Lucy here?
No,
she's okay. All right, today is what day? Today is what day?
Saturday.
And yesterday was?
Saturday.
And what happened yesterday and today till, since yesterday till today, what happened? We are getting older and getting closer to death. And we are getting more radiations. And we are getting more illuminations now, you know. At night time, you know, your face will illuminate now. When you have lots of radiations, you know, you'll be walking with the illumined face at darkness. Well, this morning, our time is, what's the time now?
20 to 9.
So we'll have class first, and then breakfast, and then after an hour rest, we'll have a talk. This morning talk I'll keep after breakfast, and 1 hour intermission, and then I will talk to you. Because we all late came, and we had to do asanas and then that, etc. Because we had to finish that. So I'll talk at approximately 12 o'clock. What time lunch?
12 o'clock. Okay. Lunch will be 10:30.
So 12 o'clock will be our main talk. Please don't miss that. What is your name? You are standing there. What is your name? What is that?
Olivia.
Olivia? You like here, Olivia? What did you learn from here? What is that?
Either nothing or lettuce.
Lettuce? They are the future yogis, but I don't know what type of world we are going to give to them. The world full of radiations we'll give them. I don't know what. Let us pray that something. God's grace only has to come now to save this world, you know. There's nobody here in this world to save us except God's grace. So repeat God's name, Om Namo Narayana, constantly. That's the only way you can save yourself and save others also, okay? So we'll talk at 12 o'clock and we'll conclude with Triambagam. And then at 2 o'clock to 2 and then 2:30 we go for a walk, even if it rains. I'll go with you, you see, so that you don't have to worry, oh, Swami is sitting and so I'll go with you. I need also some exercise and a beautiful grass and nice trees and also nearby coal mine too. You can see the black coal and green grass simultaneously. And Girish yesterday frightened me. Oh my, Swamiji, there's a nuclear reactor there. And we are going to meditate on the top of the nuclear reactor. We'll have instant illumination, definitely. We all come in that luminous phase. Okay. Thank you all. Om Namah Shivaya. That is the Triambagam, and conclude, and then your class, asana, pranayama, and 12 o'clock your main lecture. And 2:30, we go for a nice, comfortable walk. And then 4:30, when you come back, 4 o'clock, your asanas and pranayama again. And then evening meditation and satsang and the movie and there's color slide projection and so many things are there, okay? And make the mini weekend maximum possible useful. Thank you all, especially people came from Paris. All the way from France they came for this retreat. Okay? Thank you all. Om Namah Shivaya. यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकं बन्धनात् मुच्योर्मुच्छियमान्तात् ॐ त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकं बन्धनात् मुच्योर्मुच्छियमान्तात् ॐ त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमबन्धनात्मिच्योर्मुच्छियमान्तात् ॐ सर्वेषां स्वस्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां शान्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां पूर्णं भवतु सर्वेषां मङ्गलं भवतु सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाम् सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् असतो मा सर्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा मृतङ्गमय ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ adorable Lord of mercy and love, salutations and prostrations unto thee. Thou art omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient. Thou art Satchidananda. Thou art existence, knowledge, bliss absolute. Thou art the indweller of all beings. Grant us an understanding heart, equal vision, balanced mind, faith, devotion and wisdom. Grant us enough spiritual strength to resist temptations and to control the mind. Free us from egoism, lust, anger, greed, hatred and jealousy. Fill our hearts with the divine virtues. Let us behold thee in all these names and forms. Let us serve thee in all these names and forms. Let us ever remember thee, ever sing thy glories, that thy name be ever on our lips. That's the power. Bolo Sadguru Shivananda Maharaj ki. Harish, don't forget, 12 o'clock, everyone should be here. Take attendance. Okay? आरंभे विघ्नदर्शन जायते ओम शुक्लांबरधरं विष्णुं शिशुवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदं ध्याये श्रीविघ्नोपशान्ते गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वर गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः ओम नमः शिवाय गुरवे सच्चिदानन्दमूर्ते निष्पविञ्जाय शान्ताय श्री शिवानन्दाय ते नमः सर्वमङ्गलमङ्गल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थसाधिके शरण्ये त्र्यम्बके गौरी नारायण Om Namah Shivaya. So we'll continue our morning talk. The purpose of this weekend's retreat is to is the vehicle. So the first thing in yoga teaches, Sharira Madhyam Khalu Dharma Sadhanam. You got it? No. Well, you did translate? No. How come he's translating? He's not even translating. Sharira Madhyam Khalu Dharma Sadhanam. It means the first prerequisite to reach dharma or to perform dharma or perform duties, both duties in the physical world to your family, children, home, to your country, to the nation, as well as to the super world, to perform duty to reach the higher heavens or higher planes. All these, whatever you perform to reach the higher state, a dharma is there. And that dharma, first dharma is to keep the body healthy. That's all. Sharira Madhyam. The first prerequisite is the body. Take care of the body first. Then comes God or whatever it is. So the yoga masters are not imaginary type of beings. They know the practical life involved in our goal. That goal is dharma. There are other goals also there. These are the four goals: dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Those are the four. Dharma means to perform your duties. duty is to your children, duty to your husband, wife, home, nation, etc. It's called duty. And also duty to your own body. That is to keep the body healthy. That's also your duty. It's not doctor's duty. Is it? Saman Lal? It's doctor's duty to keep your body healthy, is it not? No. Drug company must make new drugs to make my body healthy, is it not? Who is going to make your body healthy and keep healthy? You are the only person, nobody else. And just I was reading the Time magazine, London Times, and the headline, whatever I said last night, exactly they were talking. I did not even know they were going to talk about that. Last night, yesterday evening talk I told, there were 100,000 people, they need care for next 10 to 20 years, they may die slowly. And that's what they said, exactly what I said now. Within next 10, 12 years, they have to constantly monitor 100,000 people's health. That is people who got radiation. And they may die from today onwards till next day, next year, 10 years from now. They'll have cancer, leukemia. But they said, they are going to monitor 100,000 people's health for next 10 years or 12, 20 years. But if they monitor, what would happen? They'll find today 10 people died. From the 100,000 people, 10 people died today. They had very good statistic record. And tomorrow they will say another 20 people died. They monitored very carefully and they told you clearly, definitely, that you are dead. They watched it carefully. And they said, today 30 people died, definitely. That's all they can monitor. What else they can do? No? They said they are going to monitor next 10 years, 100,000 people's health they are going to monitor. But what are they going to do? Monitor? Today 100 people died, next day 20 people died, another 50 people died. Until all 100,000 people dead. And the statistics completed. Well, now we are going to keep the books closed. We watched and monitored for 10 years. They all died. Now no more. That is called our governments and our scientists. They try to make you very, very happy by telling they are going to monitor 100,000 people's health hereafter. Oh, great. They are wonderful, is it not? And you are so happy. At last they said so. And printed in the headline in the London Times, the headline it came up, you know. That means even the paper people very, very much nice to report about it. So that you know that you are one of the among the 100,000 going to die tomorrow. Well, that is that. No one can give you health. You live the right life. So that is the first thing. If you want to take care of your family, if you want to love your family, first what you need? Health. If you don't have health, can you take care of your baby? No? And baby has to take care of you. Mummy, do you have a headache, mummy? How old he is, or she? Eh? Two and a half. Huh? She speaks, she or he?
Boy.
Boys. You speak? Mummy is healthy? Look, mummy, see, has got fever? Put the hands on mummy's head. No, he doesn't want to do now. He will do privately when mummy goes lying down. He'll put the head and check it up. No one is there. Mummy, you're okay.
He's laughing.
He's going to do that. Surely you'll see. One day he'll do. He'll put the head. See? Put the head like that. Hands are like that. And ask mummy, you're okay, mummy? No headache? Okay? Do that. So, even if you want to love your family and have a healthy family life, without the body, you can have millions of dollars. Billions of dollars, like Mrs. Marcos and Mr. Marcos. And they offered $1 billion to Costa Rica to give him an asylum there. Costa Rica is a small country in South America. You know that, where Costa Rica is. They offered $1 billion. Marcos' daughter went secretly to Costa Rica and told them, we'll give $1 billion. My father is dying of cancer. That's what she used this. Within 6 months, my father will die. I want to, please give him an asylum. I will give first I will give $500,000 or $500 million. We'll put you in the bank first. And then other $500 million we give when he comes to your country. And they said, no. We don't want $1 billion. Even with using this emotion that my father is dying of cancer, within 6 months he will die, please give him a place. But with $1 billion, they can't even buy a country. You have to just stay there. You understand your life? But here you can come, or you can go to Paris, you can move to anywhere, any country, you can go to Costa Rica. You don't have to pay one penny. You came here, how much money you paid to the government to come here? You from? Eh? Nothing. You come from which part? Brazil, is it not?
Yes, but now we came from India here.
Eh? No, yeah? No, but you come from Brazil, is it not?
Yes,
yeah. Brazilian. And how much you paid to come here to, I mean, did you pay government any bribe?
Only the ticket.
That's all. See, who is free? With a man with the $60 billion, they got, I think they got $10 billion, Marcos. And he has got no place to go. No one wants him, his money, nor him. And here you don't have any penny. You can move anywhere. He went to India and he came back here. And yesterday I was there in Paris, and next day I was in Germany. Another day I will be in another place. We can move. No one asks any penny from us because we don't have any money to give. But who is free? And we go and go to sleep, and I don't have to worry about who is going to shoot me down. I just walk on the street. Even I went to West Berlin, to East Berlin. If they want, they can shoot me down over the Berlin Wall. And even the Berlin Wall, they don't want to shoot me down. And when I arrived in East Berlin, they immediately came down with the sandwiches and the, all the peace. And they said to me, okay, you can go back now. You came back, you told me, no, you can go back. Because I went with flowers and love, and there's a freedom. So, if you want to do anything, take care of the body first. While doing that, that body can be used so you can perform dharma, duty to your family, home, children, and to your own happiness. Then, or that means your own happiness. Next is the purpose of the body is to make money. That's it, it's all right. Artha means next present, dharma, artha. You can make money. But in a legal way, not illegal way. If you want to do business with not more than 10%. Okay? Don't make out 10%. That's all right. And out of the 10%, you make money. You just sold certain things, you pay 10% income out of it. Then what you do? Artha, kama. That 10% in the money you earned, you enjoy your life. You can buy goodies. But not the wrong things like champagne and caviar. Buy goods which will bring you happiness. You can go for a vacation like that, yoga vacation. With the 10% you can come here. But with that 10% you cannot go to Las Vegas.
This means I can use the dharma, artha according to dharma.
Dharma, yeah, according to the law. That means you can do charity, but out of the money you earn, 10% you spend for charity, 90% you can keep it. But 90% you keep, also use it for taking care of your life, not just spending for wrong purpose. Then you have negative results. So dharma, artha, earning money, kama, you can enjoy, which is prescribed in the shastras. You can only perform those kama, or you can enjoy those type of actions, which is prescribed in the scriptures. You can have a married life, married happy life. You can buy anything to get that happiness, which is prescribed in this, not outside the way, not by selling drugs, etc. You cannot just make a living like that. So dharma, artha, kama, then next is moksha. The last thing is liberation. That's for you, not for your wife or children. You have to also find a time to reach, because you have to die alone. Because why you have to die alone? Why you have to die alone? Because you came alone. You came alone. So then you have to die. There's nothing. And nobody came with you. So you came alone. Maybe even if you are twins, still you came one by one, not all simultaneously, you see. You are a few seconds apart, a few minutes apart, even twins, you see. Don't come simultaneously. Even quadruplets and fourtuplets and quintuplets, they all come only one by one. Few minutes this way, few minutes that way. And you go also one by one. Sometimes we go all together. When the nuclear bomb explodes up there, we all vaporize simultaneously. Well, that is the type, but generally, otherwise we always go one by one, all alone. So, moksha, this, all of the things you know in your religion, in your country, you said you had to practice dharma, duty is there, that's allowed there, in your, also in your religion, in your country. Then artha, making money, also there, and also right way, everyone says, not a wrong way. No religion ever said, doesn't matter which religion is that, you have to kill somebody to make your living, or loot, etc. So that right way of making the money is accepted throughout every religion, but right way. Kama, you are also allowed to enjoy certain things, but not certain things you are not allowed to do, like even drugs, etc. If they enjoy the drugs and so forth, you get into problems. So your government itself is against it. So that is, you know all these things. But what you don't know in your country is, there's one more purpose in life, that is moksha or liberation. What is liberation? What is liberation?
Union with God.
I don't know where the God is. If I know that, I definitely go, buy the ticket next day to go to him and join him. But I don't know where he is. What is moksha?
Freedom from death and birth.
What is moksha?
Freedom from birth and death.
Moksha is freedom. Not freedom from birth or death. Not freedom from anything else. Freedom from your own enemy. Who is your enemy? Yourself. And who is yourself? A small self. You make a very small. What's the small self? Who makes that small self?
You.
Your?
Ego.
Little ego. Well, this little ego says, I must be little bigger than you. So I need a throne and hierarchy. Now I can see him. Oh, you're all my student. Bless you. God is sending my energy and God asked me to bless you all. I'm going to send you to heaven tomorrow. Because you came for a yoga retreat, I'm going to give a stamp in your passport. You are lived a good life, so you can go to heaven. And go to show, please. Definitely when you go to heaven, you can show that, you know. You will get a special place there will be for you. Little ego says, I am great Swami. And your little ego says, you are small students. This ego creates all the problems because no one wants to be small. Everyone wants to be big. And so Russia has got 20,000 nuclear warhead. Then America says, ah, is it so? So we'll have 30,000 nuclear warheads. Going to be bigger than Russia. And Russia said, we can wipe people 20 times, we can wipe out you Americans. We got enough bombs to wipe out 20 times. America says, is it so? So we are going to have 100 times we are going to wipe you out. How many times you can wipe out? How many times you can kill a person? But you see, I'm going to kill you 100 times. And he says, no, 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 I'm going to kill you 200 times. Even the children cannot, won't tell such kind of a stupid idea. But this is what our great nations and leaders are talking about. I'm going to destroy you 40 times. America says we got 100 times. And they got enough nuclear bomb to destroy this world 40 times. But they are not satisfied. They are still making more bombs every day so they can destroy more times. And these people who are going to destroy themselves will be destroyed for first attack. So, you never learned the freedom is not from anything, from our own little ego, which creates the illusion, I am different from you, and you are different from me. And how do you remove this little ego? You'll hear somewhere, someone said that. Let me see who said that. I and my father are one. I am in you. You are in me. I am he. Who said that?
Jesus.
Eh? peace, as you say. You heard that all. Everyone has heard this, is it not? Everyone heard this, is it not? I and my father. Show me who hasn't heard this. Everyone heard. You ask Billy Graham. Did he hear this thing? He knows this? Sure, he must read Bible at least once in his life. What a Pope. Pope also must have heard, definitely. But you go and tell Pope, oh, I and my father are one, is only for Jesus. Not for you. But Jesus said, I am in you. Oh, that's just a word. Don't believe it. That you don't have to believe. You don't have a philosophy to explain about what that I and Father are meant. I am in you, you are in me. Why you don't have this philosophy? Because you don't have the fourth step. Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha. You don't know how to liberate. That liberation is not in us. Only you can liberate when that I merges in everything. I am in you, you are in me. I am in the Father, Father is in me, I am the Father and Father in me. This philosophy is called moksha, liberation. You got it in your Bible, but no one ever interpreted. They said, if you are a Christian, you just born about few years ago, because one fine morning God just created you, your soul. That's what your religion says. God created you. Well, the cause because some apple, someone ate some apple some time years ago. And that's how the problem started, anyhow. But anyhow, this soul of you came only when you were born and created by your parents. Sure. Suppose your parents were not married, you won't be here. And you have no problem also. And not only you have no problem, you don't have to worry about going to hell. Because if you are born, then you have to be a good boy or a good... You tell your girl to be a good girl, is it not? Yeah? Boy, a boy. He's a good boy, isn't he? And what will you say when you say, be a good boy, what will you say?
What will you say?
Hopefully. Yeah? I'm a good boy. But not always. Sometimes he says, oh no, I don't want to be a good boy too. He will react also. Huh? He says, no, I don't want to be a good boy. I want to be a naughty boy. But if he was not born, neither he has to be good nor bad. And so forth, he doesn't have to worry about going to hell or heaven. Now, I was born because of my parents, and now I got no choice. I had to work hard for my liberation. Means what liberation? In this life, if I live good, if I just go to church and pay a couple of dollars and get a stamp every Sunday, I'm a good Catholic, or I'm a good Protestant, or I'm a good Jew, or a good Hindu, and then they'll send me to heaven, I can live for? After death, you live ever for heaven. That's what they say to you. Do you understand your thought of that? The future is infinite. You are living only 100 years, which is only a speck, a moment in the infinite time of the past and the future. This present 100 years is only one small speck. After the 100 years, you spend 50 years in sleeping and dreaming. You do not know where you are even. Did you remember your husband and child when you were sleeping? No, you've forgotten them. You love your child, son, is it not? You love your boy. But during sleep, did you remember him? Did you love him? She even forgotten him. You forgot your husband also. And you forgot your home. And you've forgotten your body.
That's right.
See? Even you're forgetting the very body you love so much, you're forgetting that also. You're not even loving your body. Forget about child, husband, etc. You don't even want to love your body. You want to forget this? Forget this? Very body, which you think you are. If you think this body you are, then why don't you love this body when you're sleeping? If you go to sleep, you are going to forget this body. And when you are going to forget the body, you don't want to drink water because you are not aware of it. And you don't go to bathroom, you don't do anything, you don't eat. That means body will die, is it not? And you don't give medicines because your body needs medicine. You don't give vitamins, minerals, etc. You think yet you forget everything, you can go to sleep, forgetting this very body itself. So, when Jesus said that I and the Father are one, there is no way for you to understand this meaning. That's what the main cause of his crucifixion. They did not understand what he meant. Because this I and the Father are one, even not only just he said, even before, in the same tradition. What the tradition? Jesus was a Catholic tradition, is it not? He born as a Catholic, is it not? Are you another Protestant? Is he a Catholic or Protestant? Eh? Who is a Protestant? He is a Jew. Biologically, he is Jew, and his disciples were all Catholics and Protestants, is it not?
Yes.
his disciples were also Jews, and he taught to Christians, is it not? He preached to the Christians, is it not? So the I and the Father, it's not merely Jesus realized or came from his teachings. This teaching exists even before in the same tradition, the Judaism. Who was the first person who heard this word, I, in the tradition, Jewish tradition? Moses. Well, in the burning bush, a bush is not being consumed by the fire, yet their fire is burning, and it has got a form or shape something. As otherwise, Moses won't ask, who are you? If it's just only fire, he won't ask, who are you? Do you ask some fire, hey, who are you? Hey, candle, who are you? So, in order to ask that question, there must be a kind of form. And to start a conversation like that, if you just go and ask, look at this water, hey, who are you? If I start a conversation like that, you are just going to think I am a crazy. You send me one here, my lecture, hey, this is a crazy man, send him to the mental hospital. So when I drink the water, I never ask, hey, who are you? Can I drink you? You're okay. So if you are cold and you saw some bushes burning, you go, hey, who are you? Can I come and warm my hand a little bit? So there must be something there. He not only saw a burning bush, but it's got some kind of form which attracts his attention. We don't know what that attraction, anyhow. Then he asks, again, you are light, you are heat, you got a form, but yet you are not disturbing the environments like burning and material. So the answer was, what was the answer? Who are you? What the answer came from?
I am.
I am that I am. I. He did not say, I am God, or I am some superpower. I got some control over all of you. That is superiority, the superego. God is God, not superego, and because the same God shines in each of us equally. That's why I am that I am. That I in you is in me. We are one. That's what. So the tradition, Jesus heard that word and he realized it. He did not repeat that I am. He realized I and my Father are one. This, where did he get it from? Where did he learn? Not even from the Moses. Moses gone long time ago. Where did he learn? Jesus, this philosophy or this realization, where did he get it?
It's
huh?
From this
Father.
Pardon? From this
Father. Okay. He's supposed to travel there. Ah, where he was, when he was, when some 7 years, 8 years onwards, till he came back to Israel, about 25 or 23 years, he was somewhere. In the Christian religion, you don't want to know about that 23 years of his life. Most. Because he lived only about 28, is not? That is max, he was 28.
32.
Eh? 32. So he left about when he was 8, is it not?
12.
Okay, 12. So 12, then about 22 years, 20 years he was? 18. After 20 years, you take about 12 years off, then
18 years. 20 years. Now, do you ever thought of that? What happened to him in this period? No Christians want to know. Now he wants to know. Because in all our life, if you want to know about Swami Vishnu's life, he said where he was born and where did you go, how many years he spent in the Rishikesh with my master, and what did I learn. Of course, this is my biography, you'll find all these things, is it not? Suppose I just born in India and suddenly I appeared here and I disappeared and then I came back and only, I'm only teaching yoga now. But in order to teach this yoga, this philosophy, I must have some training. And where did I get this training? So you want to know about it. Yes, I went to a master, great Swami Sivananda. And how did he teach Swamiji? Say that one day he called me and he wants to start Yoga Vedanta Forest University. And I came, I was just 17 and a half. Said, he's going to start Yoga Vedanta Forest Academy. Where is he going to start? So he called on a tree, under a tree. A tree was there. This is the university, Forest University, Forest University. So he said, all right, now we are going to learn from something. So who is the professor? So he called, there was only six people there, six students, and he called all the six students. Swami Vishnu Devanji, you are the Hatha Yoga professor. Swami Harisharanji, you are the Bhakti Yoga professor. Swami Chidananji, you are Raja Yoga professor. Swami Krishnananji, you are the Vedanta Jnana Yoga professor. And where are the students now? All bigger students now, every bigger professor there. No. He started the Yoga Vedanta Forest University and everyone became teacher, professor there. Now who is going to learn? Sivananda became the disciple. He became the Vishnu Swamiji, come on, talk about Hatha Yoga. Krishnanji, talk about Vedanta. Harishan, talk about Bhakti Yoga. And who is the person who is listening? Sivananda. That is the way it is. Started the Yoga Vedanta Forest Academy. I went to learn, but he did not make me a student. He made me a professor. So I told Gurudev, I don't know anything about Hatha Yoga. Gurudev, I just came to learn about it. The next day, you come back here and you are going to teach. So naturally I was worried about, because how am I going to talk about pranayama? I don't know, A, B, D, C, D, the things, etc. Is it? So I started reading some books here and there. To make something, I must present before him, I am a professor now. Let me just start reading. Various books I start reading, and some physiology book I took about where is lungs, I don't know. Because I studied little physiology chemistry in my school, I want to remember now where are those things now, where the diaphragm, where the lungs, and where the intercostal muscles, etc. I brushed my old memory from the school, which I forgot a long time ago, and I came here and I started talking. You remember, there is a diaphragm by which you breathe. Gurudev said, stop with that nonsense. And he touched me, everything will come to you. Like a floodgate opened from the past, maybe things start pouring. You won't believe it. That complete illustrated book of yours, all the asanas, pranayamas, I never learned anything. Just master touched me, opened my past memory. Because you are not born first time. Every one of you contains certain amount of knowledge in the subconscious mind in the time immemorial. You are born several million times before. Each incarnation you added your memory little by little, little by little. It's all there. But each time when you come, we block that and put a new memory over it. It's just like a sediments, after sediments. And what you did is just remove that plug and start coming up the submerged memories. And that's why how I learned. First, everything I'm talking is my experience from the past. And then I put on more experience. I put my body into a kind of laboratory and experiment in many ways, various type of yogic exercise, bandhas, mudras. I practice morning, midday, evening, midnight. Four times I do pranayama, morning, midday, evening, midnight. And 8 hours it takes. intensely practice, see anything truth in this type of life, or they are merely talking. Because I don't accept anything merely by book reading or by someone. I have to experience in my life. Without experience, I won't teach anything to anybody. If I don't have the experience, I won't teach you. So I invited them. I know the naturopathy, clay, cabbage, and naturopathy, nature cure, etc. This India is quite common. But I don't have too much belief, though I believe in nature cure, because I can't just go and tell everybody, you have to, no more infection. If there is, please, don't worry about antibiotics, just put some clay over it. I will never tell that, because what would happen if the person dies? I don't know anything about it. Someone says so, I won't do that. So God punished me to make me to realize it. So I got a frostbite in the Himalayas, and they rushed me down, with soldiers came and brought me down from 15,000 feet down. And then they gave me a jeep, and when the land became more clear, and they gave me a jeep, and the jeep and I collided with an old injury came back, and my head, knee, everything is in, bleeding and turmoil. Anyhow, when I came back to Clinic Longwood in Frankfurt, and they just took off all antibiotics. In India, they used to give me heavy antibiotics. They took all the antibiotics, infection was there, and my diabetic sugar shot up very badly, and knee pain and head pain and everything. My body is almost unbearable in pain. They took off all these things and put a clay over the oozing wound, literally, in oozing wound they put it. And no more antibiotics. My God, I would have had a heart attack. Someone is putting in an infected wound, putting some mud over it. What do you think about it? But in 2-3 days, then afterwards, they put cabbage, raw cabbage. They put cabbage over it, and after clay, cabbage, and little hot water treatment, and cabbage and air treatment. Within a few days, I had no sensation on my foot. All the sensation had gone. Even if you cut it, I won't feel anything. The clay start bringing the prana. It draw the energy from somewhere, which is not coming down. And I slowly could feel the sensation in my feet. Not the infection has gone, sensation start coming. And the clay will be harder due to heat of the body. And then they take it off, and then air for 2 hours air. And 2 hours they gave cabbage. Sometimes whole night I had to put cabbage during the first few days, cabbage patch packet. And then daytime they remove it, and then give 1-2 hours air, and then they had to go for foot bath for another 20 minutes. Hotter water start, the temperature starts at 37 Celsius and reached up to 40 degrees for 20 minutes. Then come back and 2 hours air. So air, water, heat, fire, and then clay, earth, and cabbage. That kind of invisible energy either, because cabbage, the juice itself is like a very antibiotic, you know, the raw cabbage. The no germs can thrive in that, you know. It opens up the wound, the clay contracts everything, and it draws, because it dries out, you know, so there's no air, and the heat and the air. And then the cabbage opens the opposite purpose of the clay, and then I felt in my body, my God, it really worked. If you don't believe it, I can show you. How is that? You must have seen that. Got the one brochure of that? Give me one brochure, bring it up. You got one. So look at that. Only a little bit of that. They already cut about so much flesh, that 3 feet they cut down. It's all grown up now, you see. Just clay and cabbage. And in India, they gave me heavy antibiotics. And with both inside to take antibiotics and outside antibiotics. But without any antibiotics, just by natural method, here it is, you can pass it and you can see, this. Put it on the bulletin board, it's only one copy. Okay. And you see, look at my foot, you can see, put it on there, that one, as they go, they can see it. Put it on the door. So, I experience in my own body, yes, what we heard about the prana, I can believe it. Again, I know about the prana works in the Himalayas. I was there for, I want to be in 6 months, but 3 months. I went during the winter times, 15,000 feet, because no one can come up at that time. So I'll be free from anyone. They cannot even send a telegram to me, because there's nothing there except snow. And unless you send some bird there, no one. And so I spent six months, but 3 months only I could spend. But in the 3 months, there was no heat, no firewood even. Temperature, average temperatures inside the cave is about 0 Celsius, you see. And for 3 months, no heat, and washing hands with cold, ice cold water. Once you touch that water, you know, your hand will burn. But you put it this way, that's the only way you can warm up the hand. Just your body heat, you know. And I did my asanas, and the pranayama gave me the heat for me. I could survive that cold. I had no problem at all with the heat. I can just go on, live forever in that cold, just performing the pranayama. So I know the prana works. yogis know that when they go in the Himalayas, they don't need heat because the body creates a kind of energy. And then when I came to Clinic Langhur, I learned actually that earth, water, air, fire, ether all have the same effect. The prana there in each of the natural elements have the prana. We drink the water, you draw the prana from that, then you take the clay. In fact, they even give the clay, not only for clay outside. You know, my secretary had some stomach problem from India, she had my dysentery or diarrhea. And they reported that they gave a glass of clay, and you, three times you take the clay. So she was eating clay actually, for the inside, it worked. Clay outside, clay inside, so also cabbage. They put cabbage, and they are for my food also the same thing they gave. Cabbage for eating, cabbage, lettuce, in fact, the roots. His theory is all the energy must come, prana must come from the healing agent, must come from the whole plant. So they gave me roots, like radish and other roots, then stalk, like celery, leaves, like cabbage and lettuce, fruit, like cucumbers, tomatoes. And so the entire plant, they gave, including some sprouts also there, you see. That's all lunch and dinner. Breakfast, they gave you a kind of cereal, uncooked cereal. They keep the wheat soaked overnight. And you got it this morning? You had it? Yeah, that's the thing, the recipe from there. And it's ground overnight, they keep soak it and then grind it with the apple and the cream and some honey. And that's all. There's no cooking. That means nothing is destroyed. That life is still there when you are eating that. So they give the live food so the body can draw the energy from the live food. And a dead food, like meat, etc., you won't get anything. It's only dead. And only get disease like arthritis and heart trouble. That's what these are not doctors I'm talking, Indian doctors or yogis are talking about. Modern doctors, German doctors, who have been trained in the Western allopathic medicine. They're all very highly qualified doctors. They know all Western medicine, antibiotics, and surgery, etc. In that whole clinic, they only give this. Morning, that's a cereal, they get it. Two times, they give rest of the things. It's just whole plant and one fruit it added. My infection, outside infection, inside infection, it's all gone. Nature itself. So this type of things, Jesus also taught. In the Dead Sea Scroll, it is there, you'll see. I'll go to that little bit now. Jesus, before that, I'll just say, what happened to Jesus' life, just like I said, I learned from my master, he touched me, but still, I spent about 10-12 years in the Himalayas before I came to the West. Master said, go ahead. Now, that 12 years, I did not have my own, in fact, even that, I know all the things, I had to practice myself. I did not just become wrote a PhD degree to get a professor's degree without practicing. I did not have anything except practice. So everything I practiced, that pranayama, asana, etc., four times and experience, then I came to the West. Suppose if I take my life only, I was born, I went to 18, up to 18, I was studying the schools, and I was 2 years, I was in the army. The British was ruling at those times, the World War II. I was in the English army, British army. And then suddenly I went, after the war, I joined the Gurudev's ashram for another 12 years I spent there. And then I came to the West. Now, when I came to the West, if I forget all those things, that period I went to my master, what I learned in the Himalayas, etc., you don't want to know, only just you want to teach us, if I start teaching yoga without knowing anything, then you start complete. This is what happened to Jesus' life too. Christianity is reeling now because they don't want to know these things, but they're afraid. Not Christian people. Who is afraid? Who is afraid? If they know what happened to Jesus during this absent period of time, because there's a learning, there's a time he was learning. And if they learned about the whole truth, what would happen? That's the Pope will be out first. There will be no Pope because he was not talking in that term. Jesus was, they know that the Vatican has got the entire manuscripts and even in the Kashmir in Tibet, in the Tibetan Lamas, they got in their monastery visit of the Jesus. They call it Saint Isaiah, they call him. And they mentioned about how he came a saint from the Middle East and they lived with them. So he traveled to Kashmir, Tibet, Benares, he moved with the Brahmins and even talk and even discussions with them. The philosophy he learned, the yoga technique he learned, is from the East. He was the first yogi to come from the went to East and then learned everything, came back. And in the Tibetan Lamas, there is a book, they written, and when he left the Saint Isayam, they call him Jesus, and next caravan route came back, and it is still there, mentioned in their manuscripts. That Saint Isaiah, they call him Saint, came back. He did not come back, and he was crucified. So when the message came, it is there in their manuscript how Saint Isaiah was crucified. Now, this point is the point missing in the Christianity. They are afraid, the present Christian people, if they start talking about the true Christ life, they have to know about what Christ did during this period of Advent. They said, no, you don't have to know anything about it. Because Jesus Christ came from the heaven and he's going to, he went to heaven and waiting for you all. And you come and spend money and take a stamp. And that's why Catholics and Protestants are killing each other. Because they don't know anything, the truth about the Jesus. And now they want to know about it. So in this condition, that Jesus said is, I and Father are one. I am in you. He has got no superiority complex or inferiority complex. He never said, I am the great man and you are. If that is so, he would not have washed the feet of his disciples. He would want to, externally he wants to show that he has got no inferiority or superiority. He must that I, the small little ego. And then the test came, the highest test. His life was about to be destroyed. On the cross, he had psychic powers also. Just like if I have a gun, someone is going to come and attack me. If I have a gun, what I would do with the gun? I just keep it back. Hey, you can shoot me. I'm not going to shoot you. Immediately, I defend myself. It's accepted. You can defend yourself, is it not?
Yes.
Jesus had the capacity to defend himself. Not with the gun, with the psychic powers. If he had the power of other psychic powers, like he can stop the storms, etc., he had the psychic power to just burn the cross. And 1 second, he could have just blown up everything. He could have done that. Very easy. And he could have destroyed all the people who came to crucify him. He can do under the law of self-defense. If he had done that, what would have happened? He used his power to destroy his enemies. Then what would have happened? He would have saved his physical flesh and lost the soul, the I, the soul. But his philosophy is not philosophy. He realized I and Father are one. I am in you. So the people who came to destroy him, who are they? His own self. They do not understand this I. They thought the body is the I. So you are not God. So we'll show you how. They put some nails on this body. Naturally, it started bleeding because Jesus was breathing like everybody else. He has to eat food to survive. That's the body. But the I, they did not understand those days. Even now, the Christians don't understand what he meant by I. So they were talking resurrections and coming out from the grave and then just going up to heaven, etc. All types of nonsense they brought. But still, they don't want to know the truth. They are afraid. They're just like the ostrich, buried their head under the sand. Some of these people are burying. That's why Christianity is going. Look, the beautiful monastery. There's only two monks here. You know, it's sad. Those days must be so many people, nuns and monks will be living here. And now no one wants to come in this because the truth has been changed. Because they are not talking the real Jesus teaching. They are not even following. Jesus originally, he was a Jew. He was not a Catholic or Protestant. Now I just go back to Dead Sea Scroll, that's this evening talk, morning, afternoon talk, and evening I'll go to deep philosophy into yoga. The relationship between the East and the West, that's what I'm, because we are all in a monastery, and here also, it's a very spiritual atmosphere, because still the many people meditated here, the Christians are nuns, makes no difference, they're all people who try to find the self. That's why the spirit of renunciation means dharma, artha, kama, moksha. That's why the people renounce in every religion. These type of religious people are there, whether Catholic or Protestant, monks, etc. They're all interested in liberation. So they live a simple life. So I'm going to take you to the first aspect of Jesus' life, how he lived. I'm not talking merely my imagination alone, but there are I read the certain literatures about the Jesus in India, and also I read some of the things in the Dead Sea Scroll. You know the Dead Sea Scroll? Huh? Is it? Okay. Do you have a yoga teacher training manual? Anyone has got a copy here?
Yeah.
Okay. Please bring that yoga teacher training manual. I'll just take a small portion. You won't believe it. What Jesus really taught, the true Jesus is. He taught whatever I got in the natural clinic. He did the same clay treatment for the people and same type of fasting and so forth. You will see that. I'll try to get the... Huh? No. That, I want the teacher's training manual. It is only your teachers will have, nobody will. That's for our... I'll just come back in a few minutes, okay? I think the training manual, I want to see the shape of it. I mean, please chant on the one I ran. Come on.
Om Namo Narayana. Om Namo Narayana. Om Namo Narayana. Om Namo Narayana.